Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about Oracle Optimizer, histogram and the bind picking. So first of all, we are going to see the histogram. See, by default, Oracle collects the general information about the column data, such as a high value, low value, number of distinct value, but does not always collect the information about the distribution of the data within the column. This information is not collected, but other information Oracle collects by default, that is the high value, low value, number of distinct value. Okay, if the data in the column is fairly evenly distributed, the default statistic will be adequate. But if the data is unevenly distributed, the optimizer might need a histogram to determine the best plan. Right? If the data in the column is distributed properly, fine, then evenly distributed, then okay, plan is okay, statistics will be fine. But in case the data is unevenly distributed, the optimizer might need the histogram to determine the best execution plan. In this case only, if unevenly distributed, then and then the execution histogram is required for the best execution plan. Here, let's see this thing with the example. The distribution of the country ID column in the this table name, customer, the vast variety of the customer in the few well-known country and the United States along account with the 33% of the customer. Okay. Without the histogram, all the optimizer knows is that there are 19 distinct value in the country ID column. Okay. If we seek all the customer for the particular country, the optimizer choose a full table scan even if the country code corresponding to the Saudi Arabia is provided. So here you can see this thing with this diagram. See, here maximum customers are with the United States of America, but for the Saudi Arabia very low customers. Fine, but whenever you are executing the query on that time, like you want only data from the Saudi Arabia customer, here also the table, full table scan is done. Okay. If you require the maximum data for the if you require the data for the United States of America, that is fine. On that time it is using the full table scan because maximum all the data you require from the table, but you require the very few data on that time, it should use the here index scan. So here the creation of the column histogram enable Oracle to recognize selective values with the within otherwise unselective column or vice versa. The optimizer can then choose the use of index for selective value, for example Saudi Arabia, and the full table scan for non-selective column, in this case the United States. So once you created the histogram, after that what happened here, it will use the full table scan, but here it will use the index scan. Fine. So after the histogram is created, the query for the United States remains unaffected, but the countries for queries for the Saudi Arabia customer use for the index. So that is the main purpose of this creating the histogram over here. You have an index already there, but here whenever you are selecting the data, it is for this, it is also doing the full table scan, for this it is also doing the full table scan. Fine. You are, whenever you are selecting data with the United States of America, full table scan. Whenever you are selecting the data from the Saudi Arabia, it is doing the full table scan. But the important thing is that once you create a, because this is unevenly distribution of data in the your table column. So once you created the histogram, after that it is just use the proper, it will just generate the proper execution plan. That is the purpose of the your histogram. Next, Oracle database use the following types of histogram. One is a height balance histogram, another one is a frequency histogram. Okay. The database stores this type of histogram in the histogram columns column called tape column statistics view. Fine, or user or DBA. This column can have a value of height balance, frequency or the none. So here you can just check it out, tab underscore column underscore statistic, you can check it out which histogram is created, whether it is height balance, frequency or none. Height balance histogram. Okay. In the height balance histogram, the column value are divided into the bucket so that the bucket contain approximately the same number of rows. Fine, bucket contains the same number of rows. Okay, the histogram shows whether the endpoint falls into the range of the value. Okay, so consider the column, find my column with the value between 1 to 100 and a histogram within the 10 buckets. If the data in my column is uniformly distributed, the histogram looks similar to the figure. Fine. So here the data is distributed evenly. Fine. The 10, 10, 10, 10, 10 here up to 100. So that is fine. Okay. For the example, 7 bucket rows value within the 60 and 70. So 10 values are there. So this is evenly distributed data. Fine. The number of rows in each bucket is 10%. Okay. The total number of rows of the total number in this example uniformly distributed 40% of the row between the 60 and 100, because this is evenly distributed. 10 here, 10 here, 10 here. So that is the 40% of the data is evenly distributed between 60 to 100. Okay. If the data is not uniformly distributed, then the histogram may look like a figure. So here, this is the figure of the histogram. In this case, the most of the row have a value 5 for the column. Only 10% of the row value between 60 to 100. Fine. Only 10%. Here 40%. Here 10%. This is the how the histogram looks like. That depends upon the your data distribution in the column. Frequency histogram. Okay. In the frequency histogram, each value of the column corresponding to the single bucket of the histogram. Each bucket contains the number of occurrences for this value. For example, suppose 36 row contains the value 1 for the column warehouse ID, the endpoint value 1 has an endpoint number 36. The database automatically create the frequency histogram instead of height balanced histogram under the following criteria. So here, whenever you have a number of distinct value is less than or equal to the number of histogram bucket, that is up to 54, by default the 54 value. So if you have a number of distinct value is less than the number of bucket in the histogram, fine. That's why automatically Oracle creates the frequency histogram. Fine. So this is the your histogram. Next, bind picking. What is bind picking? So first is a bind variable picking. So the in the bind variable picking, also called as a bind picking, the optimizer looks at the value in the bind variable when the database perform hard parts of the statement. Means whenever the hard parsing is done. Means data is not available in the library cache, it will do the parsing, hard parsing. Fine, execution plan is not available in the your library cache, on that time it will do the hard parsing. So on that time, the optimizer looks the value in the bind variable when the database perform hard parse of the statement. Fine. When the query use literals, the optimizer can use the literal values to find the best plan. Fine. However, when the query use the bind variable, the optimizer must select the best plan without presence of literal in the SQL test. This task can be extremely the difficult. Fine. So here this is the very important. When the query use the literals, the optimizer can use the literal values to find the best plan. However, when the query use the bind variables, on that time optimizer must select the best plan without the presence of literal in the SQL task. But this is the task is extremely difficult. Whenever you are using the bind variable, it is very tough for optimizer to use the best plan, because sometimes it is very tough whether here it to use the index scan or here it to use the full table scan, because sometimes it is required if you selecting maximum of the data, Oracle will use the full table scan. If you are selecting any specific data, Oracle will use the index scan. But if this thing is with the bind variable, on that time very tough for the optimizer to identify which plan is the best. Fine. So when the choosing the plan, the optimizer only pick at the bind value during the hard parse. So whenever the hard parse is done, on that time whatever the value was that on that time, only that value is used by the Oracle optimizer. Means the first time whatever the hard parsing is done, Oracle use the same value. This plan may not be optimal for the possible value. See, later on you are passing the same query, but you are changing the value. On that time, that execution plan is not fit for that. Fine. So here, Oracle introduced the new thing, that is the adaptive cursor sharing, because that is the problem. Because each and every time Oracle use the hard parsing. Fine. Oracle use the hard parsing value, and that is not the best. So Oracle introduced the new thing, that is the adaptive cursor sharing in 11g. Oracle 11g adaptive cursor sharing attempts to resolve this issue created by the bind variable picking. Fine. If the optimizer detects that the SQL might be optimized with a different execution plan when providing with the different bind variables, it marks the SQL as a bind sensitive. Means like you are initially you have passed the value, fine, like in the employee table you have passed the value like between department ID 10 and 30. Okay, later on you are passing the value like 30 and 40. But whatever the plan is used during the 10 and 30, fine, the same plan it will use between 30 and 40. But that plan is not based. So on that time, what the Oracle will do, if the optimizer detects that SQL might be optimized with a different execution plan when provided with the different bind variables, it will mark the SQL as a bind sensitive. Fine, it will mark if it finds that with different bind variables, the best execution plan is different, SQL plan is there, better execution plan is there, that then it will mark that statement as a bind sensitive. Okay, when the SQL is executed with the different bind variables, multiple copies of the SQL might be cached, fine, and each with the different execution plan, different value, different plan. Okay, hard parse, different value. Soft parse, again you are passing the different value, so different SQL statements are generated. So it is storing multiple same SQL statement, storing into the memory or into the V$ SQL with a different SQL plan. Each copy will be assigned to the same SQL ID. Fine, SQL ID will remain the same, but with the different child number. Here the child number you will find the difference. We can see all the different plans by scanning the V$SQL to find out the SQL ID and then executing the DBMS experiment plan or display cursor to show the various plan. Fine. So for the same SQL statement, you have a different plans. Why? Because you are passing the different values. So this is the very important thing, that is the adaptive cursor sharing, and it is only available in the 11G, and it will just mark that your SQL statement with the bind sensitive. Fine. Okay. Bind sensitive cursor. What is the bind sensitive cursor? So a bind sensitive cursor is a cursor whose optimal plan may be depend on the value of the bind variable. Fine. The database monitors the behavior of the bind sensitive cursor that use the different bind value to determine whether the different plan is a beneficiary. Fine. The criteria used to optimizer to decide whether the cursor is a bind sensitive includes the following. The optimizer has a picked at the bind values to generate the selective estimate. The histogram exists on the column containing the bind value. Fine. So this is the your bind sensitive cursor. Another one is a bind aware cursor. So what is the difference between these two? The bind aware cursor is a bind sensitive cursor eligible to use the different plan for the different bind variables. Fine. So here what happened? Database monitor the behavior of the bind sensitive cursor that use the different bind values to determine whether the different plan is beneficial. Here it is just determined. Here is a bind sensitive cursor eligible to use the different plan for different wire values. Fine. So that is the difference. Okay. After the cursor has been made bind aware, the optimizer chooses the plan for the future execution based on the bind value and its selectivity estimation. When the statement with the bind sensitive cursor is executed, the database decides whether to mark the cursor bind aware. Fine. The decision depends upon the whether the cursor produces a significantly different data access pattern for the different bind variable. So that depends upon the your bind values. Fine. If it is generating the different execution plan, means some changes are there, then it will just mark as a bind aware. Okay. If the database marks the cursor bind aware, then the next time the cursor executed database does the following. So here generate the new plan based on the new bind variable. Fine. It will generate the new plan. Okay. After that, mark the original cursor generated for the statement as a not a shareable. Fine. So here in the V$SQL is shareable, it will mark as a N. And this cursor is no longer usable and will among the first to be aged out from the shared server SQL area. Fine. So this is the thing is happen whenever you are using the bind aware. Okay. Whenever the Oracle is using the bind aware. So let's see practically how to use the histogram and how to use this bind picking in Oracle database.
So first of all, for the histogram, what you required? You require to be like statistics should be gathered. If the statistics is not there, you cannot use the histogram, you cannot take the benefit of your histogram. So first of all, let me just check sys as a sysdba, and I am just taking the table called dept under the Scott schema. Fine. And here first of all I will check whether the statistics is taken or not on the table name called department number. Fine. So here I am just executing the statement first dba tab column statistics, where I will take the table name dept, column name dept number. Fine. So here first I am just executing the command. Here I am getting the some error. So fine. So here show user, SQL plus sys as a sysdba. Fine. Connect. Here no need to connect with anything. Fine. And just execute this command. So here you can see the no row is selected. Fine. And the very important thing is that statistics is not gathered on this table, so you will find nothing. So first of all you need to just gather the statistic. So whenever you are gathering the statistics and whenever you want to just want to create the histogram on it, what you can do, you can just gather the statistics dbms underscore stat dot gather table stats, owner name Scott, table name dept, method opt for the column size 10, dept number. Fine. So what does it mean? According to this, it will just method opt, according to this, this will just create the your histogram. If you are gathering the statistics only with this, so here, see, here I am just gathering the statistic. So this is the first, I am gathering the statistics on the table. PLSQL procedure completed successfully. Fine. And now again, if you are executing the same SQL statement, and here you will not find anything related to your histogram, that is the none. Number of distinct value on the department number 4, number of bucket is 1, and histogram is none. Now here if you want to create the histogram, what you need to do, you need to just take the your statistic using this column, that is called this. Fine. Method of column size 10, and I am taking the statistics, and this is the statistics I have taken, method opt for column size 10, department number. So here you can see whenever you are taking this statistics, and again if you are executing this, you can see the height balance histogram is created. So number of distinct value 4, number of bucket is 4. For the each and every value, one bucket is created. So initially it was the number of bucket was only 1, now 4 bucket is created. Fine. So here once you created this buckets, fine, and here when you check this SQL statement, endpoint number, endpoint value, dba tab histogram, where department table name equal to dept, column name dept number, order by endpoint number. Fine. So here you can see this thing. Fine. So here endpoint number 1, endpoint value 10, 2, 20, 3, 30, 4, 40. So whenever the new value comes, any new value you are inserting, okay, that value is going to be inserted under the your new under the individual buckets, that is the balance bucket. So here you can see if I am inserting the new value, insert into scott.dbt values. Fine. That is the DSC Scott.dbt. Fine. Select insert into dbt values Scott.dbt values 10. I'm just inserting 50 test location test. Fine. One row created, select star from scott.dbt. Fine. So now you will get the 5 values. Now if I am checking the same thing again, fine, and here I am executing the same thing again, fine, number of buckets 4 with the high balance. Why it is showing you 4? Because we have not gathered the statistics on this. If I am gathering the statistic again, here you can see, and again if I am executing this, number of distinct 5 and 5 buckets are created. So this is done, means whenever you are taking the statistics automatically, it will just balance the your histogram. Fine, and here if you are checking the values, 5, number of endpoint 5 and value is 5. So in this way, Oracle, whenever you are gathering the statistics, Oracle automatically creating the your histogram. Fine, so in this session we have discussed about the histogram and the bind variables. Thank you.